हेलो स्टूडेंट, दिस इज राशिद खान फ्रॉम एलपीएम पब्लिक स्कूल गोला बाजार गोरखपुर। हियर वी हैव टू डिस्कस ऑन द टॉपिक गिवन एज प्यूरिफिकेशन ऑफ कॉपर, हाउ द इम्प्योर कॉपर गेट प्यूरिफाइड। द प्यूरिफिकेशन मेथड इज बेस्ड ऑन द इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस प्रोसेसेस। सो वी कैन से दैट बाय द इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस ऑफ कॉपर there will be the purification method could be followed. So in case of a purification of copper, there will be two rods taken as a pure copper and impure copper, and which is dipped into the electrolyte which is made up of copper sulfate solution. This is the total setup in which the electrical current passes through. What will be the effect when the electrical current passes through? That copper decomposed completely into the electrolyte. In this electrolyte there is a sulfate and copper ion gets separated, and by the complete decomposition the copper get attracted towards the, that is, pure copper, and the impurities which is not get collected over there at the any rod or any terminal, so it will has to be deposited over the surface that can deposited on the bottom. How it will happen? It's a complete procedure. There is the method when there is electric current is passes through which the purification is done. How it is done? It is a very simple, taking a two rods in which first one is pure copper and second one is impure copper. When there is an electric current flow through the copper, this is act as a positive and negative terminal. So the negative terminal of the copper will be the pure copper, and in case of impure, that will be on positive terminal. So here will be the electric current are attached to them. Next, these two poles are act as a electrode, that is a anode and cathode. These electrode are dipped into an electrolyte, that means in a copper sulfate solution. So in a copper sulfate solution, this solution in which the copper gets separated from the sulfate solution, that means they both are the ions present in the solution, will have to be separated from one another. When the electric current flows, the copper which get deposited over there, the pure copper, and the impurities which is not deposited are stuck anywhere else. So it will has to be just collected to the bottom, and this one is called as impure or impurities. This impurities is get collected. How it happened? Let's observe a activity through which we can be see how it's happened. In case wherever the here we have to try to make a setup. In which the purification is done. Suppose it is the vessels, and this vessels is filled up by copper sulfate solution. This vessel is filled by the copper sulfate solution. So in which there is two poles are there, these poles act as a electrodes and cathode, that is electrode, that is anode and cathode, and it is on the anode and the anode there will be an impure copper. This impure copper acted as a anode, and the pure copper
This will be the negative charge and it is act as a cathode.
These two electrodes are there, anode and cathode. These two poles, that is a positive charge and that one is negative charge, as you shown in the figure. What will happen? Here is electric
current supplied to it. What will happen? When the electric current supplied to this,
when electric current supplied to this, what will happen? There will be the
electrical conductivities go through. And due to these conductivities,
this may behave like,
here is the decomposition takes place. After getting this, here is a decomposition takes place. By the complete decomposition, it will be break down into copper plus sulfate ion.
When it just decomposes into the copper and sulfate ion,
these copper are get attracted, are deposited over the pure copper, you can say at the cathode.
When it can be deposited over there,
this one is called as a pure copper.
The pure copper only get deposited over there. The rest of the other, the impurities which is deposited over there,
this is impurities.
This impurities is get deposited over there at the bottom. Why? Because it could not be attracted or diffracted, or might be somewhere else deposited, but it can be remain suspended or remain here in the bottom, and this is known as impurities. That are the method, or this is the method by which the purification of copper is getting done, or filtration of copper we can say, or it is the purification of a copper takes place. This purification indicates as wherever the impurities gets on any metals, this can be deposited, can be purified by the method of electrolysis as well. So it is another method on which the electrolysis process takes place. Through the electrolysis, there will be the plating done. Through the electrolysis, there will be the purification done. Through this, there will be another process called as, suppose it is anode and cathode, and this is not the copper. Suppose if it is an stainless
steel. Suppose it is an steel,
and here is
chromium rod. This one will be chromium.
Sorry.
If it is chromium rod,
so you know very well, for protection as well as for coating of
one metal towards another metal,
or to one metal by a conducting material.
Here is in which the steel, there will be the current passed takes place.
So we can say, when there is a chromium plating gun, this is the setup for what? It is the setup for
chromium. So here will be the chromium also may take place.
Here we can say in this regard we can say that here is the also a process takes place.
Suppose it is a stainless steel, and due to the
rusting, it is coated with a chromium plating. It is called as a chromium plating. This chromium plating takes place by means of electrolysis as well. How it happens? Here is suppose steel and here is chromium. So by the decomposition of these chromium, the chromium metal or the chromium rod, when the electric supply passes through the, it is placed at anode. The chromium placed at anode and the steel placed at a cathode. And when an electric current passes through this, what will happen? There will be the electricity provided, and after that it can be decomposed in iron, and these ions get deposited over there and the stainless steel. What will happen if it is deposited over there like this? So there is a coating form. This coating is known as chromium plate. By the formation of chromium plate, it will be very important to check out or to prevent from getting rust, or it can make more attractive the material, or the conducting material make more conductive, so it can be more attractive, so it can be drawn or it can be get coated with an chromium metal. By chromium metal, if there is any material or metal which is got rusted or might be their appearance are not so good, if it is not shiny, so there will be the process takes place, that is called as a chromium plate, chromium plating. By the chromium plating, if there is some other metal which is got fade or might they have caught the corrosion, so there is a process known as a chromium plating. By the process of a chromium plating, this chromium has to be adopted or get stuck towards the other poles on which there is a steel is placed. So steel get completely plated by the chromium, and due to which it can be very safe, it can be prevent from get rusting, as well as it is very brighter or it is very shiny and may be very attractive as well. In another form, if there is an bathtub or any other spoons like this, suppose it is a spoon, suppose if it is a spoon, so what will be the process, how it will be get plated? Suppose if it is about silver, if it is made up of the silver, so it is act as a cathode as well, and here is the chromium. If the electric current passes through, so these chromium are get deposited over there at the this spoon. What will happen? Their coating takes place. There will be the coating takes place over the spoons. This is a spoon and this is the silver spoon on which the chromium get deposited, and their color, their shining, and they can be remain, they could not be just rusted. Why? Because due to the use of the chromium. So it is a chromium plating. So this is all about that the method of electroplating or electrolysis in the form of electroplating, chromium plating, zinc. Suppose if there is a setup for, it is a setup for, here is iron rod as a cathode, and here is zinc. It is a zinc rod act as a
anode.
What will be happen in that case?
Some certain things happens.
How it happens?
This could be happen by, it is this is the zinc sulfate.
If it is the zinc sulfate and this one is about the zinc and that is by the iron,
so here will be
from getting rusted, the iron could be prevented by adding or by applying the method to electroplating. By the process of electroplating, when the electric current passes through,
when there is electric current passes through, what will happen? There will be
electrical charges flow, and due to the flow of electrical charges, what will happen?
This zinc is broken into the completely dissolve or completely decomposes. By the decomposition, these zinc get deposited over there at the iron rod, and these iron rod are then it is brighter or shiny, and
this is now shiny
and can have a layer of what? Layer of zinc on its surrounding.
So what will happen if there is a zinc surrounding to it? This can have a very important. Why? Because the zinc prevented from getting rusted as well. And this will be a very attractive by the coating of a zinc. So this one is called as a zinc plating. Zinc plating is takes place to prevent from getting rusted as well as make it very brighter or shiny,
that their appearance, their looks will be so good. So in this manner
we can use the electrolysis. So these are the different type of application of electrolysis through which the electrical conductivity takes place. In the next video we will certain talk about the next topic.